Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the most common Toyota 1GR-FE engine problems. The Toyota 1GR engine is a 4-liter V6 produced from 2002 through the present day. It's primarily found in trucks and vehicles like the Toyota 4Runner, FJ Cruiser, Tacoma, and Tundra. Now, the 1GR-FE is an incredibly reliable engine and offers really a good balance of performance, reliability, and longevity. Really, these are all major reasons as to why the 1GR engine has lived on now for over two decades and is still found in brand new models to this very day. But anyway, with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss the most common problems with the Toyota 1GR-FE engine. Number one on the list, we have head gasket failure. Head gasket failure really isn't something that is a serious or very prevalent issue on 1GR engines, especially newer engines produced after 2005. So looking at 2006 and beyond, Toyota addressed this issue and quickly resolved it. This is really something that affected primarily 2003 until 2005 models. When it comes to the head gasket failing, oftentimes the issues stemmed from the head gasket right around cylinder number 6. That seemed to be the most common area for head gasket failures. So clearly there was some sort of design flaw or issue around that portion of the head gasket, which was again redesigned by Toyota and mostly eliminated head gasket issues moving forward. Even on these earlier original engines that had head gasket failures, a lot of the times these failures didn't actually just happen out of the blue. There was some underlying issue with the cooling system or with the engine overheating, and overheating on any vehicle or engine can cause head gasket failure. So it seems like maybe part of the weakness had to do with overheating, and the head gasket design might have been fine and totally acceptable on vehicles that would never overheat. As one final comment, we are talking about an engine here where some of them on the road today are 12, 15, even 20 plus years old, and head gaskets are something that is a wear and tear component and something that can be a common problem on a lot of different engines after they reach the 10, 15 year and 150,000 mile ballpark. And so something to keep in mind if you are in the market for an older 1GR FE engine, that a lot of the times an older engine does require a little extra TLC, and head gaskets are one of those components that tend to wear down and fail over time. Moving on to our second common problem, we have ticking noises. Ticking noises oftentimes are a serious issue and really might not even indicate an underlying issue. A lot of the times it can simply be an annoyance in hearing that ticking sound coming from the engine, but there are a few different potential causes of the ticking noises coming from the 1GR. Starting off, number one is noisy injectors. A lot of people have noticed and claimed that the 1GR injectors are just naturally loud and noisy and that they can sometimes produce that ticking sound that some people may hear and think there's some other issue or something potentially wrong with the engine. Another common cause of ticking noises, there's actually a pulse width module on the driver's side of the engine that is secured into the plastic intake piping with a little 1 millimeter bolt. Over time, this 1 millimeter bolt is known to loosen a little bit, and then it can knock around and kind of rattle around the plastic and produce that ticking sound. So if you're hearing that on the driver's side of the engine, check that PWM bolt and see if it's potentially loose and the cause, as that's a very simple fix. Simply tighten the bolt back down and that should knock out any of the ticking noises that you may be hearing. And then moving on to the third potential cause, we have lifter tick. So lifter tick is one of those things that usually doesn't indicate an issue. However, the 1GR FE actually uses solid lifters. Unlike hydraulic lifters, solid lifters do actually necessitate valve adjustments. Toyota recommends doing these valve adjustments every 5 years or 60,000 miles. However, the engine uses shim style design, and with that, that can often last about 100 to 120,000 miles before you actually need to do any valve adjustments on the engine. So ultimately, if you're hearing ticking noises, it very well could be lifter tick, especially if your engine is due up for valve adjustments. If you're around that number even a little bit sooner and you're noticing ticking noises that have recently developed or are suddenly getting worse, then it very well could be a sign that you simply need to adjust the valves on the 1GR FE. Last but not least, moving on to our final common problem, problem, lump something together very generic, and just wanted to talk a little bit more about age-related issues, because again, we are talking about an engine that was very popular in a number of different models and is now 12, 15, 20 plus years old in some of the older variants of the 1GR-FE engine. Naturally, all older vehicles and engines are going to run into a couple extra problems here and there. Nothing to hold against the 1GR because these aren't true design problems or really issues with the engine. And again, this is really something that can be said about any older car and engine, is that certain components, anything like hoses, gaskets, O-ring, seals, really any rubber or rubber-like or plastic components simply wear down and degrade with age and mileage. They begin cracking, becoming brittle, and ultimately that can lead to things like coolant leaks, oil leaks, and other issues of that nature. So something to point out that oil leaks, coolant leaks, things like that are going to be more common on some of these older 1GR-FE engines, and that's just the nature of owning an older car and engine in general. So that wraps up the three most common problems for the Toyota 1GR-FE 4-liter V6 engine. So in summary of everything and talking a little bit more about reliability, again, as I mentioned right towards the start of the video, the 1GR-FE is an incredibly reliable engine, and that really ties into a lot of the reasons Toyota has kept this engine around in so many flagship models for over two decades now, really a testament just to how good and reliable and efficient and effective the 1GR-FE engine is. So circling back to the problems in summary a little bit, I talked about head gaskets, but that's mostly an issue that affected earlier 03 to 05 models. A lot of those should have been rectified by now, either had the head gasket replaced back in the day, or if they didn't fail and were never replaced, then it's likely just a good head gasket and not something that's any more likely to fail at this point now that we're talking about, you know, a 20-year-old engine. So very minor issue in the grand scheme, especially as of now in 2024. And again, props to Toyota for addressing this issue as soon as possible, which seemed to be a good remedy and long-term fix for the head gasket issues. And then otherwise, we talked about the ticking sounds, and that's just something that, again, a lot of the times it's something that's not even an underlying issue or problem with the engine. Instead, can just be more of an annoyance than anything. However, if you're hearing those ticking noises, these engines do require valve adjustments, which isn't a problem with the engine. That's just how they were designed. So that's something to consider if you are running into ticking or lifter tick sounds. Otherwise, again, very reliable engine. Some older ones may run into some age-related problems, but certainly nothing to hold against the 1GR-FE. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more. Thanks, everyone.